Now we're down in the basement of the Faraday's Museum. It is set up as a display space, but as I explained a bit earlier, it hasn't been accessible to the public for a few years now. But we do have an interesting collection of artifacts down here, which we hope to show to more advantage in the new museum on King Street. One of these artifacts is this Quebec stove, which is down here. It was actually manufactured in Prescott, probably in the 1860s or so, by a firm named Jones and Dowsley. They were a foundry outfit that was originated on the riverfront. Mr. Jones established a foundry there in the 1830s. But by the 1850s, the railway came to Prescott, the one linking Montreal to Toronto, the Grand Trunk, and the one linking Ottawa to Prescott, the Prescott Bytown Railway. And so Mr. Jones went into partnership with Mr. Dowsley, Matthew Dowsley, who was a Prescott native, and they established a new foundry up at what was then the north end of town on the railway line, just east of where the railway station is, now at 500 Railway Avenue in Prescott. So they manufactured a broad range of cast iron items, such as this stove, but also fences and agricultural implements and all sorts of other things, and shipped them through all of eastern Ontario and into Quebec. It was quite a large company. We have a picture of it here as it appeared in the 1860s up in the north end, and there's a car here, and the location of the foundry is more or less where Prescott Finishing is today, in the upper end of Prescott, just south of the railway line. Another item that we have here, several, are post office boxes. These are very early post office boxes from the original post office in Prescott, which was located in this building from the late 1820s onwards. Alpheus Jones was the postmaster of Prescott. He started it in 1816 from working in Fort Wellington as the postmaster for the region. And then in 1828, he received a commission from the postmaster to become Prescott's postmaster. And he held that position for the rest of his life until he died in 1863. Over here, we have a picture of the soldiers who went to war in the Second World War. And I don't know if we can swing around, but over on the right here, we have a setup that would be familiar in a forwarder's office, with a desk for clerks and with ledgers to enter in all the transactions that the forwarding business was doing. Forwarding itself was basically a transshipment kind of business where goods and people were transshipped at particular points. And Prescott was a great forwarding point because of its strategic location at the head of the rapids between Prescott and Montreal, and between Prescott and the Great Lakes, where you had no rapids. And so the larger ships from the Great Lakes would come as far as Prescott, would unload all their goods and passengers, and then the goods that were being transshipped down to Montreal would go into smaller boats. This occurred all during the 19th century until you had a system of modern canals, which then spelled really the end of the forwarding trade by the end of the 19th century, since the Lakers at that time could go all the way from Toronto to Montreal without having to stop. But the railways continued the tradition of Prescott being a transportation hub, and so a lot of businesses still were attracted to locate in Prescott because we offered very advantageous transportation of goods throughout eastern Canada and down into the States. And so that concludes this part